Hey, Sindri, could you take a look at this?
Honestly? I don't have much else going on right now.
Ah, offerings to Tyr. These are quite rare, you know.
Why?
Well, you know Odin, not the biggest fan of Tyr. I thought he destroyed all of these.
Found anything good in Fafnir's storeroom? Like, maybe, a whetstone?
Hey, Sindri. Have you met Mimir?
If you mean the severed head that keeps blinking at me, please, keep it away.
There is no possible way that's hygienic.
Oh, that's nice. Lovely to see you too, Sindri.
Nob.
Why? Is that a piece of my braided mistletoe arrow adorning your quiver strap? Oh, a little memento of your good pal, Sindri? I'm so terribly touched.
Very well. To business. Oh, we can't forget you. Have you made it out of Fafnir's storeroom yet?
What is this place?
Could it be? The Eight Thrones.
Stop being coy, Head. Do you know this place or not?
I'm Mimir, the smartest man alive. I know many things.
Well, whatever this place is, it looks important.
To who? There is little of value here.
Have you made it out of Fafnir's storeroom yet?
Of a language center. We should look for more like this.
seen one of those before. They look like they walked straight out of hell. I wondered what became of him.
Wait, Fafnir? Like, Fafnir's storeroom Fafnir?
The very one.
But Sindri said he was a dwarf.
He was. And now he's a dragon. Funny how life works, isn't it?
He's chained up.
Perhaps we should keep an eye out for binding shrines and free the poor bastard. Aye, lads? Source of annoyance amongst Aesir and Vanir alike.
Then why free him?
Trust the recently liberated brother. No one deserves to be held captive like this. Even a greedy little dwarf come dragon.
Question, Head. How did this dwarf become a dragon?
Well, I don't know for certain, though I'd wager his penchant for stealing magical artifacts had something to do with it. Must have stolen a trinket from the wrong Vanir goddess. Ha!
show it to the dwarves.
Time to set him free. Think he'll remember you?
I don't know, lad. A lot's changed since we last crossed paths. I had legs. You wee little bugger. Well, the dragon hasn't done much for his personality.
Boy.
Hold on. Let me read this. Beach about here.
Ulfi. You were taken from this realm too early. You who walks among the living, my beloved Gulvi calls to me. She yearns for peace. Yet her remains lie in pieces. I beg of you, make my Gulvig whole again.
You want us to collect her bones? Gross.
Gulvig's Sather magic knows no bounds. She can reunite you with those you've lost.
Really? How?
Boy.
I can smell your grief, child. Rest assured, her magic is strong enough to create bridges between life and death. If only for a short while.
Boy, we are leaving.
They've taken three of Sweet Gulvig's bones and spread them across the lake. Bring me her bones, child. Gulvig will reward you.
Good. The special chisel is ahead, past this gate.
Thank you.
Father, maybe we should look for those bones.
Why?
Didn't you hear him? We could talk to Mom again. If we keep an eye out
look
while
if
we...
you wish, boy. I will not be distracted by this fool's errand. This chisel we seek, what is it?
I'm glad you asked, actually. I have just the story for you. There was a giant once named Thamur. A very giant giant. Who, despite his mountainous size, was without question the greatest stonemason this world had ever seen. Proud Thamur hoped to one day pass his vast knowledge onto his son. But young Hrimthur had the heart of a warrior. Perhaps the father had too much fear in him, or the son too little. Either way, a quarrel of theirs spiraled out of control, and the overworked stonemason, bonk, struck his son. Hrimthur ran off into the night. Feeling shame and regret, Thamur chased after his son. But in his emotional state, soon found himself wandering Midgard, lost and alone. Sadly, he caught the eye of the one person he didn't want to meet alone that night, so far from home. Thor.
And? What happened next?
You'll see.
Thor killed him. Oh no. He fell in the village?
Aye. When Thamur fell, he crushed a charming place famed for worshipping the Vanir god Njord. Thor always took credit for planning that one. The truth is, the sweaty ball bag just got lucky.
Dangerous beast. We will take him down together.
Tip of one, yes. A very, very giant chisel.
That big crystal on the giant's ring looks promising. Darn, that didn't seem to do anything.
Magically sealed, I'm afraid. Brother, looks like that crystal's brimming again. Oh, neat trick, lad.
Thanks. That's his idea. What happened to the survivors?
Oh, Thamur was a frost giant. When he died, his final breath froze everything.
This is locked up good.
Atreus, to me!
Find the tip of that chisel. That's the magic we need.
Enemies. I'm ready if you are. Interesting. And I'll find Light Crystal. Wonder what it's for.
Can you read it?
Sir. To Njord, we offer back the sea's bounty.
Ah, yes. It was believed that Njord calmed the winds and seas for the fishermen. For that, they loved and worshipped him here.
Hey, pardon the old priest that. That's Andy. That did it! How are we getting down there?
I have a plan.
You do?
Do not act so surprised.
Oh, no offense, brother, but I don't even think Thor with Mjolnir in hand could get through that much ice.
Then Thor is a fool.
This should be entertaining.
Boy.
Ready.
Wow, that was something, that fight. Here, catch. Well, that was a waste of a perfectly good hour.
How were you not seen? There is nowhere here to hide.
Oh, that. It's a little trick my people can pull. A special way of not being seen.
You can be invisible?
More like I can step into the realm between realms. And your mind doesn't understand what it's seeing, so it sees nothing at all. That's how we avoid ever having to actually use the weapons we craft. It doesn't seem to work on dragons, though.
Your brother wanted to know if you're getting enough to eat. I guess I could tell him you are.
Brock was asking about me?
Was there meat on his breath? you let him touch this again. Come on, then.
So that's how Brock was in the temple right after the water drop. He stepped between realms.
Okay, now shush. I need complete silence for this. There you go.
To work we go.
If I say so myself.
That looks amazing. How about you, young one? Happy to provide.
So, this plan of yours.
Can you guess it?
Knowing you, it doesn't involve standing around here.
Correct.
But how do we move forward? Hey, Sindri, could you take a look at this?
Honestly? I don't have much else going on right now.
The travelers.
Ugh, disgusting. Smelly, covered in God knows how many little beasties, but gorgeous armor. Let's see if I can't make something more sanitary. Yes? Just make sure you watch each other's backs in the storeroom. Wouldn't want to lose my loyal customers. Well, don't buy anything on my account.
We heading into that building?
Yes.
You think there's something inside that'll help us break the ice and get to the chisel tip?
No.
I'll keep thinking.
Came here on a diplomatic mission once, trying to broker a peace between Asgard and Vanaheim. That war. So many lives lost. What I didn't know was Thor had already gone on a killing spree of giants.
What did the giants have to do with the war between the gods?
Nothing at all, lad. That's the tragedy of it. They took no side in that madness. But Odin's paranoia is surpassed only by Thor's lust for blood.
another crystal. Just give the word. Huh. What now? Most of it.
Well, a stealthy plan it is not.
Now we must free the other strap.
We do?